Skyrim with a character that I've been building on here to master the skill of unarmed combat. Freeloader Joe! Yes, and of course, if you're going to make an unarmed combat build, you definitely got to go with the Khajiit, because they do phenomenal unarmed combat. And the reptile Argonian guys just look really weird, so we're just gonna chill with our sorry guys, trying to get my back stuff pulled up. There we go. Let's turn that down a little bit so it's not feedback. Okay. So last night I kind of got the initial start for my character here, Freeloader Joe. I went ahead and ran down to Riften. There we go. We went down to Riften, and there is a set of gloves that you can get here in Riften. For anybody who didn't know that, that give you unarmed combat bonus. I did do the fortify restoration loop, but I'm primarily trying to use that only for some of the basic skills, like smithing, carrying capacity. Kind of trying to keep most of it legitimate for the most part, so it's not like way superly killer overpowered.
I don't claim to be the best blacksmith in White. Yorland Greymane's got that on him. Man's steel is legendary. All I ask is a fair chance.
With the exception of armor, because obviously armor is kind of a key piece to any unarmed combat build. I do need to forge myself some heavy armor. Sorry about that, guys. Ooh.
Looking to protect yourself.
I need to start gathering supplies. I kind of started doing that last night. I don't really think there's much that I need. I do need ring and armor, or ring and necklace, steel armor. 52. It's awful heavy. Was some of this that I needed to get rid of. Okay, so weapons and armor can be... Oh, I wish the shopkeeper actually had a million. That would be great. Carrying capacity.
Don't forget to check inside the shop if you need anything.
You've been a good friend to me. Blades, helmets, pretty much anything to suit your needs.
So, yeah, okay.
Good doing business with you.
Oh, yes, that's right. Steel, iron. Iron boots. Okay, so some of the stuff I'm just going to take to improve.
Welcome to war. To
give myself... Ooh, steel dagger.
Plenty of steel for fighting men.
Give myself a little spending leniency here. Okay, we'll go ahead and improve these.
Put on some clothes.
I don't remember if I had those on or not. Let's see. Stamina. Okay, yeah, I got that on. Oh, I don't have any steel. Okay. Let's see what we can do with some armor here.
Got some good pieces out here.
Steel plate.
More inside.
Now, ultimately, the goal will be to get Daedric armor or bone armor.
All I ask is a fair chance.
Okay, so I need steel. Oh, a whole lot of steel. Iron, steel, ignits. Iron. Weapons. Okay, so remove the bow. Okay. Bone molds. Gotta go kill me some dragons and some nets. I guess there's a little bit of traveling still to be yet to be done. So gonna go ahead and get those on. Iron gauntlets. Carrying capacity. And there was one. Okay, so that was my alchemy ring. Man, I really wish it would let you rename a ring after you've crafted it. There is quite a bit of gear that I need to just flat get rid of. Okay, so let's see. Honestly, these guys here seem to be about the best area to get. Okay, I don't want to do any chance. I need to get more material here, so go ahead and run the loop on these guys a couple times.
Welcome to War Maidens. Now don't let the name worry you. We got plenty of
steel. Drop a quick save. What pap?
Small weapon. Looking to protect yourself or deal some damage?
So, looking for ebony. I wish there was just some plain old ebony. Because I don't need archery. Glass armor. I'll take it.
Good doing. business with you. What do you think you're...
Do a nice little rotation here.
You look like looking to protect yourself or deal some damage.
Ebony helmet. Orcish armor. That's got 50 rating of 52.
Most of our way. Take a look.
Just some just good old ebony gauntlets. Two-handed do 20% damage. Oh, son of a... Yeah, I kind of forgot to do that.
All right then.
All right. We should have enough supplies now to get some crafting done. I don't know if I can get what I can do as far as glass armor. I can upgrade that. Okay, I got 9 ebony ingots. I can level up a little bit quicker. Okay, what can I do? Alchemy. Okay, I need to put that into smithing. And actually, I need to rescale that.
I don't claim to be the best blacksmith in Whiterun. Yorland Greymane's got that.
Go ahead and improve boots.
All I ask is a fair chance.
Approve again. We need some points. Okay, so that's my entire tree. Let's see. Can I make any more ebony? Ebony ore. No. What can I make? Okay, so I got ebony gauntlets. Armor, the boots. So I got armor, boots, and gauntlets.
Looking to protect yourself or deal some damage? Don't forget to check inside the shop if you need anything.
Items, apparel.
I don't claim to be the best blacksmith in Whiterun. Yorland Greymane's got that honor. Man's steel is legendary. All I ask is a fair chance. I help my father.
Help!
Yeah. Does a pretty good bit of damage, like.
I don't claim to be the best blacksmith. I help my father with the finest weapons and armor.
Leather, just to make some sail pieces.
You think all the counsel my father provides?
Okay, so that's my ebony armor.
Let's just say I advise the advisor and leave it at that.
Oh, hey, I need a helmet. Can I even make it a moment?
Out with it. Need something? Out with it. Got some good pieces. Have you met my father? Blades, helmets, pretty much anything to suit your needs. Looking to protect yourself or deal some damage? Don't forget to check inside the shop if you need anything.
Round and round we go.
I don't claim to be the best blacksmith in Whiterun. Yorland Greymane's got that honor. Man's steel is legendary. All I ask is a fair chance. I help my father in more ways than people realize.
Oh, don't tell me that it closed.
Welcome to the finest weapons and armor.
The ox. Okay. Well, I think that does it.
Good doing business with you. We've got small... Looking to protect yourself or deal some damage? Mm-hmm.
All right, it's time to go do some enchanting, and then head out into the wild blue yonder. I guess it would have been... Whoop. It would have been quicker just to fast travel, but...
It's no fun getting pushed around all the time.
What? Oh, okay, so I know that I need to upgrade. So I get fifths of steel. And was it two-handed attacks? Or was it single? Okay, so yeah, it's the dual fury armsman. So single, so one-handed and heavy armor both need to come up. So we need to make.
Oh, I thought you.
Gosh, I don't even know if I might have to actually go back and grab more materials for. For this. Okay, items. Created potions are. Okay, 1 million. Okay.
What are you still doing here? The Jarl said retrieving
enchanting,
that stone tablet
so
is a priority.
I can make.
Remember?
Four. Speeches at 100. Okay, so that's really all we need there. One-handed and heavy armor. So only 15 in. Okay, so we can drop a couple more in alchemy. Some pre-planning here. So need unarmed. Health, magic, stamina. I don't know if I'm really gonna shoot. Okay, so I got three and four. So six pieces to.
I thought you were already on your way to Bleak Falls Barrow.
And I'm gonna go ahead and drop a quick save before I do this. Items, potions. We just about get everything enchanted that we need. Weight.
I thought you were already on your way to Bleak Falls Barrow.
Unarmed. I need water breathing. Magicka. I think I took too long. No. Okay, so I need... Okay, let's look what we got. We got stamina, capacity, unarmed. Magic. Ring and a necklace. Sneak and lockpicking. One single-handed. Well, it's time to go start picking away at
tried mercenary work? It might suit you.
So what's the highest quality weapon I can make? Elven? Elven sword, 15 base damage. Sword, I'll hand it to it. This Nordic sword looks pretty freaking awesome. Okay, so let's go ahead and make a Nordic sword. Glass. Ebony. To enchant them. Oh. Apparel. I need a smithing ring. This dagger might actually be better off. Just because the dagger swings so much faster. I do need more material for potions. I really wish I could have gotten it on stream. Like, when I first came up here to the Ancestor Glade, I was a level 1 and managed to get in and out of here at a level 1. Past these Spriggan. There's 3 of them in here, dude, and they whooped the tar out of me. But I did manage. I managed it. Good old Faendel here was like, I used him as bait, obviously. I'll give you some example here of how I actually did this. Okay, so you got three sprag in here. There's one here, one up here, and one over in this area. So, if you're coming up here, it is possible to do this at a level one. So what you do is you take Fandle here. You tell him you need him to do something. And then you send him on a suicide mission, so to speak. Make sure you're sneaking.
At last, a worthy opponent.
Oh. See, these Spragan, dude, these guys do so much damage, it's ridiculous. Like, it's insane how much damage these guys do. Seeming this frickin' bloody jerk off over here went and, like, ruined my groove. Alright, well, before I was so rudely interrupted by that stupid cultist guy, you take a Fandale here, easiest follower to get, obviously, for anybody who's played knows this. Take him, have him, you tell him you want him to do something, target the Spragan, have him attack it. While he's attacking it, you sprint up across here, and across here. And once you're past this corner, you're golden. As long as you don't linger around, they won't follow you down here. But this is a fantastical place. I love it. How did I get such an amazingly strong character on any of my characters? Well, I went and caught some moths and picked some pretty flowers. I came down here last and did this and collected all of my flowers and moths. I had over 50 of each. So if you're doing the Fortify Restoration loop, this is absolutely the best area to come for if you're playing Special Edition Skyrim. Or if you have the Dragonborn DLC, where you can use the ancestor moths, and the yellow flowers, the yellow mountain flowers, because they are bloody, they're everywhere here. There is an absolute boatload of yellow mountain flowers and moths. So we'll go ahead and check inventory after I get done, because they are everywhere in here. They're absolutely everywhere. and there are also some little hidden pieces of like armor and weapons in here. I think there's a couple. I found a couple of coin purses, but generally there's a helmet, some other piece of armor right here underneath these monoliths or megaliths, whatever you want to call them. There was also a piece that I found sitting under water. I don't know if it's just a one-time find. Wouldn't seem as though they respawn. And you find a lot of supplies here for, like, fortify your bartering, health potions,
I've got your back. Let's get going then.
And I still haven't figured out what you need to harvest the canticle bark. I don't know if there's a particular quest that you have to obtain. What's the matter, Jazz? Not even really sure what it's for. In my digging around YouTube, I haven't found any references to it. This little area up here. So much stuff in here. Ah, yes. There's a shield. I don't recall if I had grabbed that last time. Coin purse, A little bit of jingle in your pocket. So I think that's a full round here. So that was 25 Ancestor Moth Wings. And 60 Yellow Mountain Flowers. Pretty incredible. Honestly, it seems like I should have more Ancestor Moth Wings. But you can make multiple trips out here. I think it's... If I remember correctly, this all resets after two game days, two in-game days. So if you leave this area, wait 48 hours, and come back, everything in here should be reset, so you can come back in here and harvest this all again. Primarily after I've done the restoration loop once, the only thing I ever come back here for is moths, for my Fortify Enchanting. Yes, that's right. I still needed to go to Markroth. There is a particular headpiece. I need to acquire.